Just as in humans, the population of aging people and dogs are increasing. What myself and colleagues at our site in Lewisburg in the States did was follow a very large number of Labrador retrievers from being young adults right the way through to their end of life, taking various measurements twice a year as they aged. We decided to do the study because nobody really knows how dogs age. They don't know if it's comparable to humans or whether it's very different. So we didn't know how to provide the solutions that older dogs needed. It's a really big undertaking to have a very large number of dogs that are treated just as dogs at home are treated, and to take measurements from them over that whole length of time is a huge amount of work. You have to look at lots of different things to measure the effects of aging. So very simple things like how the animals look and how they move and their body weight. But you also need to look at what's actually happening to the different systems inside the dog. So you have to look at their immune system. You have to look at how the cells in the body are aging. So there's lots of different parameters that you need to look at to get a whole picture of how an animal is aging. So we're looking at various chemicals inside the body, for example, antibody levels. We're also looking at chemicals that tell us about whether there's inflammation happening as the dogs get older, and also how the cells are aging. So how DNA is being affected, or how the proteins in the cells are being affected by aging. What we saw was that dogs actually age in a very similar way to humans. So their DNA changes, the proteins in the cells change, and the ability to repair those changes alter as well. We also looked at the immune system and saw that various levels of different antibodies in the immune system changed.